Don't know who is behind that mask of his, but I do know when we need him. And we need him now.
Yes, Commissioner.
Great Scott! Do you mean the Bat Buddies still need to know more about generic
cowls? And more Plasti-dip?
I'll take care of it right away. The Bat Holes.
Take you out in the Batmobile, maybe fire up the back computer, show you a few things, but it's way too cold in here right now. Alfred's putting in central heat in the air, and he takes a while. Anyway, you don't want to see this. You want to talk with me about costumes, come on.
Hey, Bat Buddies, I'm Paul Roberts, RT1. All right, we're going to do this Plasti-dip thing. I've done it a million times before. Let's do it.
You don't mind if I change into my Mr. Roberts attire? For the cold storm we've got out there. It's supposed to be the worst one we've had. Apparently we're sharing it with the whole nation. It's freezing in here. But the other part of the Bat Cave is freezing too, so it's a little bit better over here than it was in the other part of the cave. Oh, let's get these out of the way. Okay, so the next thing I'm gonna do, and I'm not gonna probably have this on video. This is the 25th anniversary returns cowl. The next thing I'm gonna do is the 30th anniversary cowl. I'm gonna do a few things a little bit differently. This is a key of the original, and I want to make it better first and then remold it. So that's what I'm going to be working on. One of the things that I don't like is the smoothness of this. It's too smooth. I want to see a really tough ridge right there, like that tough ridge. Things like that. I want the scallops to go like this rather than smooth like at an angle like that. Different things, just little things like that. I want this really heavy duty indent. Furled eyebrow there instead of this nice softer one. So that kind of stuff. So let's make some more room. That's better. All right. So let's go up top and I'm gonna do this Plasti-dip cowl because everybody's always asking me. I mean, you could go down the list of the things and see where I've Plasti-dipped other things, but people always wanna have new things. So I figured, they want new things? Okay, we'll do new things. But it's the same thing for this time anyway. Let's go up top.
I might do some things to get the texture even more accentuated. Let's see how this comes out first. Plasti-dip now has this great top like it used to have again, which is wonderful. One of the first things I should probably do is put down brown paper. Why make a mess? So, you know, you would think, just do this. But there's a little bit of texture. And I'll probably make sure it gets down there in that texture area. Only ways to do that is to do the dabbing. But I'll stay away from the parts that are really smooth. I purposely went smooth right on the facial area, but I'll go ahead and just do a little bit there. Just a little bit there, and I'll hit it again. I'll go real heavy right in that one little area there. Because I want that to be smooth and nice. Kind of like picking and choosing what I'm doing. That's real heavy. Remember, I always say I recommend a light coat of Plasti-dip, and I do. This isn't going to flex very much. This is the size that this is going to be. I'm going to use it for my own personal collection. Not going to stretch it any further than this. We start getting up here to these ears. I want them to be smooth too. A little nice and heavy with those. Because that is not going to move. And this will make it even slicker. And even more dependable that it's going to be not moving. So I'm just thinking about the areas as I go. And I'm varying what I do based on what the area is. A little bit more on there. I've got a texture up top there that I don't like that much. Since it's so heavy, I'll go ahead and put a little bit more on to make it more subtle. Nice and smooth here on the side. Right there in that little area. Right there in that little area too. I want that to show up a little bit. The slicker you make it, the more it'll show up. So I'll probably slick that at the end. I'm actually thinking that what I may do on this, I'm kind of jumping ahead of myself here, is show you some texture techniques that you can do. And that will be with different colors. Not different colors, but well, it could be different colors, quite frankly. On my Arkham cowl, I use different colors a lot of times. But this is not armor. But yeah, a little bit of different color wouldn't hurt, wouldn't hurt. A little more smoothness on there. There. I'm happy with what we got here. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and just take this brush one more time. Only on the textural areas, where I don't want that gloss look. I'll force it down in there. Do I want those collarbones to be more slick like that? I don't think so. Let's see what happens if I go like this. That's it for the front. Let's do the side. We're already smooth here. I've got a nice cold rainy day to work with this. A great way to use Plasti-dip. I've had times in Florida where it could even get like oxidation and grayness with it. Gone too fast, too hot, could be a problem. And I'll go ahead and I'm gonna go up underneath these scalps just a little bit, put them on the sides. Remember, this is a sealer. So even if you don't see it, it's good to seal it in. Depending on climate and other conditions, latex can oxidize a little bit. Before I go any further, make sure I get the excess off. I want the texture in these areas even more. I don't want the shine necessarily, but things are looking better already. Right down the middle, both of these ribs, down the side, let's treat them differently. Side's got more texture. Let's go ahead and make sure that texture shows. I wouldn't mind a little slickness there, but a little bit of something going on. Is that a bad idea? And then a different thing in the middle. Okay, and we could say we're almost done, but we're not gonna say it because I'm gonna do some different stuff just to say you can. Another important stage, all right? I'm gonna go ahead and make sure I get the bottom of all these scallops, the edges, I should say, of all the scallops. Because as I said, I'm sealing this. No one's ever gonna see down here, but I wanna seal it. So that's what I'm doing. All right, got that covered. Another thing I like to do is hold the cowl upside down and do these areas better. Chin, nose, under the eyebrows, eye sockets. And we could say for anybody's standard cowl, that would be all you'd need to do if you're happy with the texture. You didn't have a problem or a little spit or whatever that you wanted to get off of there. Sometimes it spits. You want to go and whenever you see the spit, if you're on, especially on a smooth finish cowl, you want to kind of go dab it, dab it, dab it. Take that little spit off. You don't want that little one little thing showing more than all the rest around it. You don't want that. I want to feather in my smooth areas with my textured areas a little bit where I can see now. I want a little bit different. I might want to double up on my heaviness there. Give a little more slick quality on those raised areas, but don't want it to be totally slick. Kind of feather it in a little bit on the sides. So it's different, but consistent. All right, what are we going to do now? I'm gonna try some things, let's see. I'm gonna take some white. And I could use the Plasti-dip, but I'm not going to, I'm gonna use the black. I'm gonna mix up a little bit of a gray. Kind of like we do with the utility belts and whatnot. And I'm gonna start dabbing it. Dab, 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 dab. I'm gonna get just the tops of these areas are gonna start picking up the paint off the brush. Right there, look at that. So it's almost like what I'm doing is I'm producing an effect. Kind of like theatrical lighting effect, but it's not lighting, it's the brush and the color changes. We don't want to go battle scar, like there, where there's an area like that that's messed up. I'm going to fix that. I'm not going for battle scar, but I want that little edge to show a little bit more. So I'll probably do some hand stuff later on. I'm not going to touch these areas, unless I want a nice little highlight on the edge there. Maybe I could put a little bit like that. And then once I've done a little bit of this, I say to myself, did I go too much in some areas? I think I did in a few areas. I'm going to go back over. I'm going to dull those down just a tad. I'm going to leave them there in place. Except for that one part I was telling you. I want to take that off. And then just a little bit more. I want to actually show these areas looking like they're even more raised than they are. Now I really want to get rid of most of the paint on my brush. And I want to really go heavy now. And really dry brush it. What I'm going to do after this is I'm going to take, after I've got this extra ruddy stuff showing through, it's too much. I'm going too much intentionally. That's too much intentionally, okay? I'm gonna do it on the back too. A little too much, and then I'm gonna dial it back with Plasti-dip. Whatever level I think it needs. All right, just like that. Look at that great texture that's already there. I'm gonna accentuate certain key areas, like maybe the scallop tips and the edge, okay? So you're looking at this and you're saying, looks like somebody did white paint on there. Yeah, it does right now. Goal is to get to where it's doing something. Look at that. Did you see that? I don't know how much you're seeing this. This isn't the best angle maybe, but pick that ruddiness up just in the areas I want, like there and there, not in the middle. And then I say, okay, this is starting to look good. It's time to bring it down to speed. I went a little heavy there. I don't want to do that. Boom, it's gone. I don't want to look like white paint. So anywhere it's standing out that looks like white paint, I'm just going to go ahead and say, okay, how far do you have to come down to have the viewer not know that it's white paint and wonder, oh, I think they just have a nice little texture that is kind of rising up, looking like a light maybe hitting it. I might want to just hit it from the side a little bit, right in there. Just dull that white down. Got a little heavy-handed up in the front area here, no problem. Now, dial it back down to where I want it to be. Now, I can keep doing this, but for my personal use, this is already good enough. Then I'm gonna go in with some paint thinner, just a little bit of paint thinner. And anywhere that I might have hit, had a brush stroke I didn't like, I'm just gonna take it off. Say that, I got a little brush stroke there, I don't want that on there. Good, clean that up. A little bit on the ear there, I didn't want any right there. Even smooth out what I do have in the areas I do want. I don't want that rough spot right there, that should be smooth. So there we go, get rid of that. That's nice there, just enough to say, yeah, there's something going on there that wasn't going on before. All right, just for the sake of making a simple little video for you all, I'm gonna say that's good enough for my cowl right now. Let's go back out. So I look at this and I can just barely tell it's there, but it's there. Well, that's a Plasti-dip cowl with just a little bit of extra oomph on the texture, a couple areas of smoothness, and he's ready to go up. Oh, where can he go? Okay, I'll find somewhere for him. So bad buddies, I'm Paul Roberts, RT1. I'm gonna be working on that key for remolding the 30th anniversary returns cowl. Why not? But for now, I have to say goodbye. But I'll be back when the day is new. And I'll have some more ideas for you. And you'll have things that you'll wanna talk about. You can do that in the comments. I will too. Talk to you later, Bat Buddies.
To the Bat Poles!
To the Bat Poles!